Good morning. It's 5:30 a.m. and making our way home.
Morning, guys. So we arrived here at our anchorage like 11 or 12-ish last night. It's a nice run down from the inside passage. Zoomed along with the tide. I think we probably averaged 9 knots all the way here.
Yes. Zooming.
Yeah. Good run. Maybe more like 8 knots. I don't know. It was quick though.
I think it's probably 8.5. Oh, excuse me.
Yeah, probably 8.5.
And we were just running really easy at 1200 RPM, so. Yeah, it was a good trip down. Or over. Or wherever.
Yeah, so we just fired up. I think our destination for today is the Tuya Bay. I guess for now, right? Because that we'll get there around 2-ish.
Yeah, gonna go in there, see if we can get in there, and check it out.
Yeah.
If the weather's nice on the outside, which it seems like it should be, the forecast is good, so. And it'd be fun to check that out, and after that, just keep motoring, I suppose. Get up to Montague Island.
Hey, bit of a haul.
Yeah.
So yeah, we'll haul the anchor in here pretty shortly and get on our way.
A little slower than the fishtail anchor.
Yeah, that's max speed.
Yeah. Give those fittings a couple of pumps each down there.
Yeah, okay.
Type bump it into gear, huh?
Mm-hmm.
That sounds good.
Yeah.
3 each or something.
Yeah.
I'll text Gus.
Alright, guys, well, there's Cape Spencer. Turn that corner, start heading north. Little bit of a swell rolling in, not too bad though.
Absolutely gorgeous. So we got really good weather on our forecast here for the next couple of days. Actually through next week. It's Saturday right now. And so we're expecting a pretty good journey home. Hopefully it holds. Seen a pot of orcas working over here. Not that way now, but too far off to see them on the GoPro, I'm sure. I was hoping they'd come in closer, but they didn't. Anyways, we're working our way up towards Lituya Bay. It's about 4 hours out right now. We're hoping the weather's good up there and we can go in and check it out, but we'll have to see when we get closer. Kind of got a fog bank building out here, so I'm hoping that burns off this afternoon. Sure is gorgeous right now, just sunny and blue skies, but it's no fun driving in the fog. So yeah, we'll check back with you guys later.
So we're just coming up on La Perosi Glacier here. Not sure if that's the correct pronunciation. There's one, and there's La Perosi Glacier there. Flowing out in the mountains.
Pretty impressive looking. Making our way up the coast. Seeing a few boats here. Pass by them. There's Mom. So we'll carry on up the line.
All right, guys, well, We just had our first mechanical issue here. Didn't lose power, but we throttled down suddenly, and it's like, oh boy, what's going on here? Thought maybe we had a plug ray core or something, which would be odd because the fuel system's really clean. Anyways, just a weird throttle system on here. It's actually a Bennett trim tap pump that sends fluid to a little ram to actuate the throttle. And it got a pinhole in it and lost pressure. So all is well. No big emergency or anything. If need be, we can disconnect it and just give it some throttle and wedge it in there. But Matt's down there fixing it now. There's enough extra tubing that we can pull it down and snip it and rejoin it where it goes into the fitting on the ram. So, yeah, pretty simple thing.
Okay, well,
guess we got it fixed.
Look at that view though.
So yeah, I guess we got that, so that thing gives us any more trouble, it's out of here. Gonna rig something up, piece of line to that throttle. Go old school. So yeah, all right guys, we'll carry on now.
All right, back on the road again after our little mishap. Another angle of that glacier. Humongous.
So in the background over here is Lituya Bay. In the 50s, there was a massive earthquake under the Gilbert Fault Line that runs right through the bay. And that gray hillside right there sloughed off into the bay, dropping the equivalent of 30 million dump trucks of rock and dirt into the bay, and spawning one of the largest recorded tsunamis in human history. So it rolled over the top of that ridge over there at 1,700 feet and then swept that whole bay about 400 feet deep, trimming everything in its path and removing all the trees and everything. So it was a pretty incredible event. There's evidence that it's happened before in the past, but there was a couple of boats that were in there at the time, and the folks on one of them made it and the other didn't, so. All the growth lower that's nice and green is the new stuff. And it's hard to see the trim line, but it's just kind of right along that path right there. At about the 400 foot level, the whole bay was just scoured clean. So pretty amazing. Anyways, I wish we had time to go in there and check it out, but we're gonna just keep rolling along here, traveling. Kind of a swell coming in anyways, and that spot can be a little bit tricky, so we're just gonna carry on. And I doubt there'll ever be another day, but you never know, maybe. Yeah, I just wanted to share that with you.
Driving.
I think we got up, around 6 and got going?
Yeah.
So that's 9:30 now. And still quite a ways to go.
Yep, got a little ways to go. Started here this morning, where this yellow spot is. Came around Cape Spencer and up past Latuya Bay. Past Cape Fairweather and coming up on Yakutat in about 4.5 hours.
Yep. It's a pretty long stretch, that trek right there. Like, we're used to, I guess, 12-hour runs.
Yep. Yeah, just back to the corner. It's been 95 miles now.
It's a good stretch.
Yep.
So, yeah, anyway, just a little status update. Go out and show you guys the mountains. I don't know if you can really see them on the GoPro, but worth showing anyway.
Stunning.
Yeah, it's stunning. Yeah, they're pretty far away now, but they're still just massive. This entire range is very impressive. Bucking the swell all day, so not the best run, but I mean, at least it's not blowing.
But yeah,
got a little floppy in a couple areas when the tide came in and ripped a little bit. So I think we have like a day and 4 hours, so 20 hours up to Kyak Island.
Yeah, we should be there like sometime around midnight tomorrow.
Yeah. I guess that's kind of our goal at the moment. We were gonna run into Yakutat over there up north of us, but it's just kind of going in for no reason just to come back out.
Unless we like sleep till noon or something.
Yeah. Cost us a few hours going in there for no big gains, so
that's just a nice nook along the shoreline, that'd be okay, but it's a little bit of a run inside. An hour, I guess, or something. Which means an hour back out.
So yeah, anyway, just a little status update for you guys. Not really much to share, but the majestic mountain ranges, and yep, and that's about it. So, I guess we'll bring you guys back in the morning as the sun comes back up. Be a little further along. See you guys then.
All right, hey everyone, EIS Alaska back at you again. So, day three of our trip, second day on the outside. It's about 8 a.m., quarter to nine, I guess, now. We've been running since 6 yesterday morning. Didn't shut down last night, just kept on motoring, so we're slowly making our way westward. Mom's whipping up some tasty pancakes and eggs for us, getting us fed. The hungry crew. Not much to do on a long voyage. read and sleep and eat and be bored, so. Yeah, that swell was kind of sharp in places. Pretty smooth, and then a little swell pop up, tide rips or something, whatever. But all in all, the travel has been great.
Yeah.
Hardly any wind and just light seas, so. Our weather's holding for us anyways, as you can see. It's absolutely gorgeous out here. About 10 miles or so offshore, it's kind of cutting this leg a little bit, so. Somewhere off in the distance is Kyak Island. We're probably gonna stop there for the night if it's nice, either on this side, the east side of it, or the west side, whichever one's nicest, and if it's rolly in there, we'll just continue on over towards Hitchenbrook Entrance and Montague Island. So yeah, just thought we'd check in with you guys, give you a little update. This weather's been fabulous, so we're really thankful for that. Alright guys, welcome back.
Hey guys.
Hey guys.
So the journey continues. We're finally at about the halfway mark. Right now we're rounding Cape St. Elias. Pinnacle rock right there, 494 feet tall, and I guess this is about halfway into our journey, so we're pretty happy about that.
Yeah, it's been a long haul, so
yeah.
Good to be on the downhill side of it.
Yeah, so it's about 9 p.m. now, let's see, we've been running for yesterday at 6.
Well, we were 40 engine hours in this morning.
Yeah.
So that's also known as Kyak Island, right?
Yeah, so the Long Island stretching kind of runs north to south. It's Kyak Island. It's about 17 miles long.
Nowhere to anchor up. So then.
Yeah. It's all right. Yeah.
Guess that's our status update, eh?
Yep.
So, onwards and forwards.
Yep.
Here we go.
See if they pop up again.
That away is home. Should be getting close to being home tomorrow evening. Late. Not sure if we'll see these whales or not.
Could pop up anywhere. In front of us, behind us. It's hard to say. Diving deep.
They are.
Looks like maybe three of them, huh?
Yeah, it smells like a lot of fin whales. I've actually noticed any more of them.
Yeah. Yeah, up there. There they are right there.
Sticking close together. All together trying to protect their young.
Not too often you see that kind of thing.
Good job, boys. You make it look easy.
getting ready to pull into the harbor. Only our third time moving the boat, so we're docking the boat rather. A little nerve-wracking. This one's a lot heavier than the old fishtail. By at least three times.
Yeah, you don't pull this one into the dock.
Thank you.
Well, good job. Got us right in here.
Yeah.
Nice and smooth.
Home safe.
Oh, fishtail.
Oh, our baby.
She's still here.
Do you want the key? Our sweet fish tail.
What about our knives? I hope our knives got put away.
They got them.
Was this bucket empty when we left?
I imagine it was, yeah. No train.
Half a bucket. I miss our little boat.
Yeah. So happy.
Good old fishtail.